Hello everyone, welcome back to English language class. And today in my class, I'm going to teach you the chapter called Degrees of Comparison, or it is also known as Comparison of Adjectives. Okay, so here we go. So first of all, consider this case. Okay, see this sentence here. Saurabh is a good singer. Sam is a good singer. Appu is a good singer. There is no change in the adjectives. Did you see? There is no any changes in the formation of adjectives. So, although the three means they are all good singers here, and none is a bad singer, they may not be equally good in singing. A comparison of the art of singing help us to express the difference among them. So here, this help us to find the difference. So that is why the chapter is known as Comparison of Adjectives. Otherwise, the sentence doesn't make any kind of sense here. Alright? But now here you see the same kind of sentence, but the adjective formation is changed here in this sentence. Like here, Saurabh is a good singer. Sam is a better singer. Appu is the best singer. Now, did you see adjective, the formation changing from here? Good, better, best. That means here, this is a positive degree. Good. Better is a comparative degree, and best is a superlative degree. So means you could see the change has been formed in the formation of adjectives. Okay, now one by one I'll explain you the rules of the formation of adjectives. Okay, this is the degrees of comparisons. Now there are three degrees of comparisons. Okay, the first one is called positive degree, second one is called comparative degree, and third one is called superlative degree. Positive degree is the first form of the degree, okay, first form of the adjectives. This is comparative is the second form, and superlative is the highest form of comparisons. Okay, now rule number one states adjective of one syllable and sum of two form the comparative by adding er and superlative by adding est. That means what you will do in the first rules, the rule says, suppose the example is small, alright. So what you do in the comparative degree, you just have to add er. So small becomes here smaller. And the superlative degree, you have to add est. So small becomes smallest. Is that clear? So you see the changes has been made here. Okay. So that is a degrees of comparison in a formation of adjectives. Another rule number two. When positive ends in E, only R or ST are added. That means any positive degree which is ending with E, like you see the word large, the word ends with E. So in such sentences, what you'll do, you'll add R in the comparative degree, that becomes larger, and ST in the superlative degree, so that becomes largest, large, larger, largest. Okay? Rule number three says when positive ends in Y and is preceded by a consonant Y, it changes into I before adding ER. So here any positive degree ending with Y, you have to change into Y, it changes into I. Like here heavy in a positive degree though ending with Y, but comparative degree this Y changes into I here, alright, before adding ER. So before adding ER, you add I first, removing Y, then add ER in the positive degree. So heavy becomes heavier in a comparative degree, okay. And coming to superlative degree, you have to add EST. Again, same way, you remove Y and add I and EST. So it becomes heaviest in the superlative degree. Now rule number four. Rule number four says the last word is doubled if a word of one syllable ends in a single consonant and in a preceded by a short vowel. So here, this type of sentence, the adjective gets the last word. Okay, suppose the word last word is here in big, G is the last word. So here, this G gets doubled and add ER in a comparative form. So it becomes bigger. And here also, the words last word gets doubled, bigger, and add EST, so it becomes biggest. Okay. Now rule number five says adjectives more than two syllable and many with two form the comparative degree by adding more before positive degree. So in such rules, what happens? Suppose you get the adjectives, the word is careful here, okay? So what you will do in a comparative degree, you have to add more to the word. So in the comparative degree, the word becomes more careful, all right? And coming to superlative degree, you have to add most. So the word becomes most careful, okay? Now, rule number six, that is the last rule here. So this rule says, this is the irregular adjectives. Now there are so many adjectives in the English language grammar, okay? So some I have taken here, the irregular one. So first one is a bad. So you, there is no such rules. You just have to memorize these words, all right? So bad becomes worse in a comparative degree and worst in a superlative degree, okay? Little becomes less in a comparative degree and least in a superlative degree. Okay, so now with the help of this, the earlier explanation, whatever I have means explained, the rules of comparisons, with the help of these rules, you have to interchange the degrees, all right? From positive to comparative, from comparative to superlative, or superlative to comparative, or comparative positive, you can change. So you just have to follow those rules, and some rules also added here. You can just see here the examples. No. In a positive degree, no other metal is as useful as iron. So here the adjective is useful. Okay. So and in the positive degree, what happens? You can start the sentence with no other. Okay. And instead, the words doesn't change. The adjective doesn't change, but you'll add just as. All right. Because means it is a positive form. So you can say no other metal is as useful as iron. Okay, now coming to comparative degree. Now, this iron is more useful than any other metal. See the changes is been made here. The word was useful here. So you, in the comparative degree, you have to add more, like I have said earlier. So more useful, and you just have to add than in the comparative degree. Okay, don't forget to add than in the comparative degree, and you can make a sentence in this way. Then superlative form. Iron is the most useful of all metals. Now here, you just added here. Here you have added the, here, sorry, than, and here you have added the. This is a superlative degree and most. So most, the earlier explanation I have already explained you. More and most in the superlative, comparative and superlative form. And here one thing is added, that is the. Don't forget to add the in the superlative form. So superlative form always you have to add the. That means iron is the most useful of all metals. All right. So in this way you can change the sentence to one to other. All right. So please stick to the rules. Okay. When you change from comparative to superlative or superlative to positive, anything. Okay. Coming to the next example I have solved here. All right. From positive to comparative and comparative to superlative. So you can change in any form here. All right. So first one, comparative degree. No other girl in the class is as good as Nalini. Okay, so here again you start the positive degree with no other, all right, so that it will be easy for you all to change, all right, from positive to comparative or comparative superlative. Okay, and the adjective used here is good, and this is the irregular adjective that I've already means told you before also. Good, better, best, there is no rules for this. You just have to memorize such words, all right. So here is the good in a positive degree. So in the comparative degree, the word is better. And the another word that is added here, than. Alright, you have to add than in the comparative degree. So, and the word, the noun will come front. Nalini is better than any other girl in the class. And the last one, superlative form. Again, the Nalini starting. Nalini is the best, and the is added with the adjective that is best in a superlative form. So Nalini is the best girl in the class. So this makes the chapter clear. I hope you have understood. Till then, stay safe, stay home.